r/AskReddit. What's something you thought was common knowledge but actually isn't? Control C, Control V, and Control Z. The amount of people that go to the top left for the undo button. A surprising number of people don't realize you should not flush hygienic products down the toilet. If it doesn't eventually back up your own pipes, it will create massive blockages in the public sewer. I had to explain this to a friend in her mid-20s. I was like, why do you think there's little trash cans on the wall of every women's stall? Edit. Did not expect people to be so passionate about proper hygiene products disposal. Love it. For anyone who's doubtful, there are plenty of horror stories in the comments below about flooded apartments, backed up sewer lines, expensive plumbing repairs, etc. Happy menstruating. Can confirm. Do not flush. Literally no one knows this. I work at a treatment plant. If you're entering a venue that requires a ticket to be scanned for entry, someone without a scanner can't let you enter. To add on to this, if you need a ticket to enter, you will actually need the ticket to enter. The amount of people I see that seem shocked when asked for their ticket and then have to dig in a bag for 5 minutes searching for it is infuriating. Just have it out while you're waiting. But I have a ticket. It's just not with me. How to use a damn roundabout. Apparently, they tried to put one in my town, but a member of our city council was publicly quoted saying that people around here are too stupid to use a roundabout. I like them already. The EU and Europe are not the same thing. The yield sign on highways are there so you look before you just keep going, possibly hitting someone. Happened to a friend's mom. If people would be cautious and look where they're going at yield signs, we could probably replace half the stop signs with them. In the area I grew up in, they had to replace a number of railroad crossbucks and highway intersection yield signs with stop signs. Apparently people are too stupid to yield to semi-trucks and ducking freight trains. I work in IT and I'm constantly helping people who don't know what the Windows key is, don't know Internet Explorer / Chrome, Firefox are web browsers, making your password your name is a really poor choice. Edit. Apparently this really struck a chord with a lot of you. Glad I'm not alone harboring all of these frustrations. Not even in IT here. A number one tip for life. Don't show that you're good with tech. At all. Ever. Yes, that's a good way to end up with two jobs for the price of one. If your wipers are on, your headlights should be on. A screensaver is the animation, or blankness, that pops up on your computer when you don't use it for a while. To save your screen from getting burned in. The background picture that wallpapers your desktop is the wallpaper. I'm amazed I still have to explain chance of rain percentages to people. Also, percentages in general. I had a 99% chance to win. How did I lose? She had an 80% chance to win. The polls lied. I remember the user on the XCOM subreddit saying the odds of him missing a 99% chance was 1,000,000 to 1. Basic geography. Not being able to point out Turkmenistan on a map is one thing. Not being able to point out the Pacific Ocean on a map is another. Iceton. And that still tells you roughly where it is. The specific ocean? Which one? Taking out your credit debit card cash out before you are asked by the cashier checkout staff saves time for everyone. Rather than looking shocked that you have to pay for your shopping. That there are no tigers in Africa. I was on safari in Tanzania and two others in the truck were discussing how excited they would be to see tigers. I told them there weren't any and they looked all disbelieving and crestfallen. Like I was spoiling their fun. They had to check with the guide. Also, a lot of people think that lions predominantly live in the jungle. Not sure why the phrase king of the jungle got so popular for lions. Even my Spanish textbook when we were learning animals and stuff had a question asking where lions live. We'd been taught the word for jungle, but not for savanna. The book wanted us to say lions live in the jungle. Yes. I had a grown-ass woman on a safari arguing with the native tour guide that of course there are tigers in Africa. And that she promised her kids she'd bring back pictures of tigers. And if she didn't see any tigers she wanted her money back. She was pissed there were no tiger stuffed animals in the gift shop. even though every other safari animal was. If you made a mistake and embarrass yourself a little for not knowing, no big deal, but to loudly carry on about the lack of tigers because you're on the wrong continent? Idiot. Posting on Reddit may mean you end up suddenly appearing in an article on BuzzFeed next week. Or YouTube tomorrow. There should be a bot that PMs you if you're in a BuzzFeed article. Tax brackets. You won't end up paying more in taxes than the extra income if you go up a bracket. Only the income above the cutoff is taxed at the higher rate. Not your total income. I had to explain this to a guy in his 60s. Literal years away from retirement. Edit. Since people were asking for an example. Here we go. Say there is a cutoff at 20k a year. 10% below and 15% above. If you made 25k a year, you would pay $20,000 times 0.1 plus $5,000 times 15 equals $2,750. Not $25,000.15 equals $3,750. Keep in mind this is a gross oversimplification. Edit 2. US taxes. I don't live in Europe or Australia. So I don't know how their taxes work. Yes. My girlfriend's mother has actually declined a raise because it was small and would put her into a higher tax bracket. In her mind that meant she would be taking home less money. My boyfriend refuses to be happy for my promotion and raise I received in February because he is convinced I've been conned and I will actually make less this year due to falling into a higher bracket. I've never been more excited to pay my taxes. How to use your debit credit card at a checkout. That the vast majority of telecommunications traffic between countries is carried via undersea fiber optic cables. Edit. Row. This blew up. I found this pretty detailed PDF that goes over a lot of the basics and details and explains it simpler than I could. For anyone looking for a visual on ARP's topic. Submarinercablemap.com link. Wow, that was really interesting to see. Thanks for the link. In Greek mythology, the Titan Atlas holds up the sky heavens, not the earth. Hey mom. Who was the first man on the moon? Tom Hanks. What a scholar she is. AD. Means Anno Domini. Not after death. I had an argument with my friend's mom a few years ago about this. She said BC was before Christ and AD was after death. I tried to explain to her that that didn't make any sense because then the 33 years of Jesus' life would just be not accounted for. I told her AD meant Anno Domini and she said I think that's the atheist version or something like that and then stopped listening when I tried to tell her it wasn't because it meant year of our Lord. To be fair. I remember being taught the whole before Christ after death thing when I was little. Not saying it's right. But it's fairly common. She's on her own for that's the atheist version. Though. Basic principles of finance. Budgeting. Interest. Debt. Saving. ETC. I still think this should be a mandatory curriculum in high school. 4 years or it. Throw in taxes as well. It blows my mind to look back and think about the amount of studying I did on topics I'll literally never encounter again, but basic financial literacy is ignored entirely. Well. My school had a 3-week assignment on the stock market, so we're all financial gurus. S. The top answers in Reddit aren't the best. They're just the soonest. That antibiotics kill bacteria. But won't do anything against viruses. Everyone has the idea that if you get a cold, you see your doctor and get antibiotics. Take some acetaminophen, paracetamol and ibuprofen. And stay away from other humans for a while. In the same line. The practice of stopping taking your antibiotics just because you feel better. It's like all these people don't care that antibiotic resistant bacteria is terrifying. And then keeping the extras around for the next time you or any family members feel mildly unwell. That you can wash blood with saliva. Any tips for acquiring a large amount of saliva in a short period of time? Asking for a friend. Drain it from all those people you are killing. Thanks for watching and be sure to subscribe to RedditQueen for the best daily content.